I am Poorna Sanjana of degree final year. Coming to the purpose of this presentation is to let you all know about eRupee, which was launched by Prime Minister in the first week of August 2021. While launching, he stated that it is a cashless and contactless instrument for digital payment. Let us see what exactly it means. In this session, I'm going to explain everything about eRupee, like everything starting from the basics. All these questions like what is eRupee, what are the challenges in implementing this, what, how does it actually works? All these questions will be addressed in this presentation, and we'll also see in which areas of UPSC eRupee falls. With respect to mains, in GS paper 3 under Indian Economy and Science and Technology, questions about eRupee can be asked. As it is a part of current affairs, we can expect questions in prelims as well that are going to be held in this October. All right. eRupee. This system has been built by NPCI, National Payments Corporation of India, in association with Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, National Health Authority, and Department of Financial Services. In this context, I would like to emphasize more about NPCI. NPCI is an umbrella organization for operating all retail payments under RBI. Let us see what is eRupee. eRupee is a one-time payment system. This seamless one-time payment mechanism enables users to redeem their vouchers without any mode of payment. And these eRupee coupons are electronic vouchers. They are e-vouchers that will be provided to recipients in the style of a QR code or a text message, via which cash will be paid directly to their bank accounts. Any government agency or corporation can generate these e-vouchers via their partner banks. Moving ahead, let us see who can issue these e-vouchers. As I mentioned earlier, any government agency or company can produce these vouchers through their partner banks. Currently, NPCI partnered with 11 banks. As mentioned in the slide, they are Axis Bank, Bank of Baroda, Canara Bank, HDFC, and so on. Let's now discuss about some benefits of eRupee. eRupee is cashless and contactless digital payment. In this COVID era and in tough times like this, contactless nature of eRupee is very essential indeed. It also ensures a leak-proof delivery, as there will be no presence of intermediary in between. We can say it assures a leak-proof delivery. Also, it is a prepaid feature. It assures timely payment. I mean, there will be no delay in payments. The user doesn't need to share any personal information. So it is safe and secure too. This eRupee is purpose-specific and person-specific. It means if they are released for the purpose of vaccination, then they can be redeemed only for that purpose. If they are released for the purpose of welfare schemes, then they can be redeemed for that purpose. There will be no dilution in that. Where we can use this eRupee? In the case of government, these vouchers will be mostly used for welfare schemes and health-related payments. Also, eRupee can also be used in vaccination drive. I mean, eRupee allows beneficiaries to easily book appointment for their shots. In the case of corporate sector, they can issue these vouchers for employee welfare programs and all. The next thing we'll see is how eRupee is different from digital payment apps. Unlike other online payment apps, eRupee is not a platform or an app. Till now, NPCI didn't release the eRupee official website or any mobile application. So the beneficiary doesn't need to have any mobile application or even a bank account to redeem this voucher. Is eRupee same as virtual currency? This is the first question that came into my mind before studying about eRupee. And I even thought that eRupee is some kind of digital currency. But no, eRupee is not a digital currency because it is backed up by Indian rupee. Let us see some challenges in order to achieve eRupee system. According to Telecom Regulatory Authority of India, TRAI report, internet penetration in rural India was only 33%. Compared to 99% in urban India. This shows we are still lacking in digitalization of rural India. This is all because of lack of infrastructure and awareness. And also there is huge digital gap among the unbanked population. These are some of the challenges to be tackled. Here are some of the long-term aims of eRupee. eRupee can boost India's GDP, which sounds very promising for a better future of Indian economy. This system will improve the living standards of common people. As I mentioned earlier, that there is huge digital gap among unbanked population. Reaching them and folding them into a financial system is also a long-term vision of this eRupee. Now let us explore some global examples of this voucher system. This e-voucher based welfare system is not a new initiative. I mean, it's not a new innovation. it was there in practice in some economically developed nations like US, Chile, Colombia, Hong Kong, and so on. This is a objective type of question about NPCI. Let us consider the first statement. NPCI is a not-for-profit organization registered under the Companies Act 2013. Yes, it is. It is a not-for-profit organization registered under Section 8 of Companies Act 2013. NPCI is a fully owned entity of RBI and Indian Banks Association. No, although NPCI is an initiative of both RBI and IBA together, but it is not a fully owned entity of them. So the first statement is true. This is a main question about eRupee. Discuss the role of recently launched eRupee in facilitating financial inclusion. In this, we should write some factual information, like some of the features of eRupee that actually assures financial inclusion in the country, like timely payment, leak-proof delivery, adequate credit to the beneficiary. And you have to assure that eRupee will somehow help to achieve financial inclusion. If you want it, you can give it a try. Either take a screenshot or kindly note it down. Concluding the topic, kindly note down, because you can also add this to the conclusion of your answer. So share Digital India, digital vision could place India on the right track towards the fourth industrial revolution. There are many roadblocks in the way of successful implementation of eRupee, like digital illiteracy, poor infrastructure, low internet speed, lack of coordination among various departments. All these challenges need to be addressed in order to realize the full potential of the program. Also, we should not forget that policy execution is much more important than policy making. Hence, let us hope that eRupee would be one among the successful initiatives. Well, that's it. Thank you, everyone.